Good morning, y'all. I'm Catherine Ross with The Street. I'm here on the floor of the NYSC with Jim Cramer. Jim, this morning you wrote a Real Money column about seven takeaways that you have in this market. Yeah. Can we talk about those?
Well, I mean, I think that I was trying to say what I think could really be on fire that you can buy on a down day. And here we go, a down day. And I was saying that aerospace is incredibly strong. That's my number one takeaway, is that you can buy anything in aerospace. You can't buy anything housing and auto. It doesn't work. You can buy things that are curing cancer. I think that Bristol Myers is a very interesting opportunity here, which they reported this morning. And you know, you got to be aware that that because world trade is not so great, you got to be staying away from some of those. But you know, my main takeaway is that if it touches aerospace, it's good. And I do want to probably talk tonight about the semis, because I was waiting to see the reaction to this the semis. Xilinx was really good. Lam Research called the bottom. Texas Instruments wasn't good, and yet Texas Instruments is going up a lot. It's a group move driven by the ETF. That's why I don't like the ETF, because some of these are going to be disappointing, some would be good. But in a down day, it seems like there isn't enough money to go around, and the people have to sell the drug stocks to go fund their buying of the semis. And now this is another piece I did yesterday for Real Money, which is that we're losing people again. People are leaving the market. And they're leaving the market for good reasons, Catherine, because the mechanics of the market aren't working and nobody really cares. SEC seems to not care. Exchanges don't care. The companies don't care. This is capitalism that's at stake. And the fact that you can't have the semis go up without selling something else means is just a telltale sign that there's not enough people who want to buy things, because there's not enough people in the stock market anymore. We lost a lot again from December.
Let's talk a little bit more about the semiconductor space.
Sure.
Because Intel is releasing earnings tonight.
Yeah, and you know, that'll be very interesting, because
it will be very interesting.
Bob Swan better deliver a good number, because and you know, they've got some issues, but they've also got some strong markets. They've got some markets that are like Xilinx, but they're a little bit behind. Eric Johnson did a fantastic piece about takeaways of Intel. But what I would say is that if this rally is going to have 2 days of strength, Bob Swan has to deliver a big number. So a lot of people are taking their. I think the semis are bottom, because I like Tim Archer from Lam. He's very, very good. I like this new guy Peng from Xilinx. By the way, there's a piece from last year that Johnson did. It was always in the spring. That's the best one that predicted what Xilinx was going to do. So people check the index. It's a really remarkable piece about Xilinx. So I like the semis, but at the same time, I wish they would cool off a little. Now, some of it may have been that I said that Lam up 9, I would still buy, and then it went up 18. It was not my expectation that I could play that big a role in that stock, but I know Lam really, really well.
Last I checked, Intel was up about 3% going into the earnings. Now, one thing that I really think is important about these earnings is the possibility of a new CEO. Andy Gauss has reported about this.
You know, I'm hoping. Look, I think Bob's doing a great job. He's the CFO. But they need a CEO, and they've had manufacturing issues, which is highly unusual for Intel, which has allowed AMD to make a big move against them. Lisa Su doing a great job. Well, allowed Xilinx to take business from them. So the only thing that Intel has been doing exceptionally right is the data center. So let's hear what they have to say. A new CEO would take that stock through 50, because it's a very expensive stock.
What about how could the new CEO impact the chip market in general?
Well, I mean, I think I'll give you a good example. Intel bought Mobileye, and Mobileye is a very important autonomous driving chip, okay, sector, let's call it. And that was very much Brian Krzanich. He went to Jerusalem, he bought that company for $15 billion. They only have 500 people. And I'm not saying it lays fallow, but I'm saying that someone needs to be able to say, listen, we're in it with Waymo. We're in it with Xilinx, which is autonomous. We're in it with NVIDIA. So, I mean, it needs extra money. Altera needs leadership, which they bought. That's the competitor Xilinx. Mobileye needs leadership. And I think, I'm not saying Intel's adrift. I am saying that when I think about Intel, it generates huge cash flow, good data center. The PCs came back. But it needs a mission statement. And a new CEO will define that. And I hope it's autonomous.
You mentioned that the market closed, or the market opened down today. It's still down. It's under 100 points. So it looks about 80 right now.
You know, you got those comments from
Wilbur Ross.
Well, and
that's what
I want
to ask you about.
I wish he hadn't said that these people should be fined and get some credit line.
And the too early to tell about a trade deal?
Yeah, too early, miles and miles. And, you know, it was out of sync with what Larry said. I know, look, I think that trade deals are complicated and they can come in pieces. And maybe we back up the march, we stay the 25%. That was downbeat. He was downbeat. I really like him, but I did not care for his comments about people going to food bank and whether that was excessive. You know, having lived in my car, some real reversals in my life. You know, there are times when there are people who struggle. And then when I got, you know, I had a lot of credit card debt. I owed people. I owed Pacific Gas and Electric. I owed Exxon. They caught up with me. And, it's not easy to get credit. And it's not easy to max out on your credit cards. And you know, you just got to be a little more sensitive. These people don't make a ton of money. So I didn't like that. I wish he would take it back. You can take it back. You can say, listen, maybe I've been wealthy for a long time, and maybe I forgot, or maybe never was.
A simple apology.
But it is, you know, it was just painful. I mean, I never took charity. I did borrow showers. Man, you got to give me a shower. I mean, I used to go to the newsroom. Hey, guys, I need a shower. Everyone knew I was homeless. And it was like, can I borrow anybody's shower? And there was a guy named Tim Carlson. He always let me use his shower. His bathroom was horrible. But better than nothing. He lived on near Centinella. And I used him as a mail drop, too. So, you know, you depend on the kindness of strangers. And Wilbur Ross doesn't seem to understand that.
Okay,
he's
so...
he's out of touch. It's okay.
I want to talk to you about Apple, because they just laid off 200 workers on their Titan autonomous production.
I mean, someone today was saying, you know, Kramer, you bagged me an Apple. Another guy said, I got an Apple. Another guy said, oh, boy, he must be long a boatload of Apple. Okay, so I can't own stocks personally. Chapel Trust owns it. I've been recommending Apple since $5. Kind of not so bad. I know that I could have called the top in Apple. I chose not to because I take a long-term view. And I'm saying that they are an innovative company, and I'm getting a lot of people pushback saying they're not. I mean, I don't know. Are they in flexible design? Are they number one in flexible design? Are they number one in 5G? No. But I rebel against this notion that they're a finished company. And yes, the stock has come down a lot. And yes, I had that story. I went to the company last week, asked them about this autonomous driving and the closing and the secret project. And, you know, I want them to focus on healthcare. I've been proposing a number of things. Ben Stato and I were working closely on how to make it so. I mean, there's just a lot of lies being told about, you know, my stance is this, okay? My stance is that I want everybody to be able to connect to the Mayo Clinic artificial intelligence work that they've done, which can predict from this whether you're going to have heart failure. I want that. I want the J&J mentioned on the call, AFib, which they're working with Apple on it. I want this because it'll always be on my wrist, and if something happens to me, heaven forbid, all my medical records will be on it. But if the medical records are with one hospital chain that is Cerner, and mine's on Epic, they can't talk to each other. And that was all I was talking about, was breaking down the silos. And I was hoping that Apple would buy a company that could help break down the silos, why I mentioned Epic. But I, you know, my whole gist of my thing is to follow up what Tim Cook said, which is about the customer. But the customer can't use the watch the way it should be. And I would gladly pay $10 to be able to have my health monitored by some handshake with the system. And, you know, no one even has said I shouldn't say that. One out of every 10 tweets says that's a good idea. What are they doing? I was talking to my doctor yesterday. But my doctors, they have an Epic system where I was. And they don't really like Epic. He said, Epic's just there. I want Apple to make it so that you own your data. That's all I want. And those who don't understand that, get out of my tweet file. You're, like, bugging me. You're just going to get Sparky and Chieftain and Bud and Pal, Captain, Skip. Got me? All right?
I got
okay?
you.
Okay?
Do you got
okay.
him?
As they say in Italy, okay?
And I want to mention that Intel is Real Money's stock of the day. So Kevin Curran will be reporting, and he
and
has already had.
We're all doing stuff.
Everyone's doing stuff. All right, Jim, thanks for joining me. It's always a pleasure to talk
absolutely.
To you. See you guys tomorrow.